Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our CxO panel. Our moderator, Nutanix Vice President of Corporate Marketing, Julie O'Brien. Senior Vice President, Infrastructure, Operations, Process and Development Ops, Accorhotels, Hamid Ben Daas. Operations Director, Claranet France, Laurent Perriault. And CIO, Consumer Products Division, L'Oreal, Josephine Darmon.
Woo! All right. Yeah. All right. Welcome. 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 I have to say, this is the point of the conference where I get very sad. This is the last session of .next. What do you guys think? Are you sad too? Yeah? All right, well, I'm so fortunate to be up here with these really distinguished customers and guests. So thank you so much for joining us. Thank you. I hope you've had fun over the last couple of days. Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Yeah. Good. So we have about 20 minutes, and what I thought we would start out is just by sharing a little bit about each of you, who you are, what you're responsible for doing at your respective companies, and then I have a few other questions that I'd like to ask. Okay, so why don't we start with you, Hamid?
My name is Hamid Ben Daas. I work for the IT of Accorhotels. I'm in charge of infrastructure and operation department. Accorhotels is an hospitality group. We have 4,000 hotels, and we are 240,000 employees. And 570,000 rooms, and we have our portfolio of brands has a lot of options going from economic to luxurious hotels. The role of my team is to design, build, and run the best infrastructures for our applications, either on premise or in the cloud.
Fantastic. All right, and Josephine?
Hi, everybody. I'm Josephine Darmon. I'm the CIO of L'Oreal Group, leader of the beauty world. I've been starting my career 15 years ago as a consultant in organization and information systems. I've joined L'Oreal 10 years ago, and since 2 years, I'm the CIO of the consumer product division, participating in the transformation of a digital company, and also supporting my business partner to expand the division position.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Welcome. And Laurent?
Yeah, my name is Laurent Perriault. I am heading the operations for Claranet in France. Mm-hmm. And Claranet is one of the leading managed service providers in Europe. We operate in 6 countries. We are focusing on web hosting and information system hosting. We have been in this industry for 20 years. And we have more than 1,000 customers. We operate large websites, large e-commerce websites.
Fantastic. Okay, well, thanks again for joining. We tend to talk a lot about work and what we do at work. But could you just share one small thing, maybe that we wouldn't see on LinkedIn, something about you that people might not know? What do you like to do when you're not focusing on the data center?
Okay. Let's talk first business.
Okay.
So I started my career as a sysadmin to have a good background on technology, server, storage, network, virtualizations. Then I took the responsibility of my department. So one of the challenges I had was to construct the strategy for the data centers and make it secure. So I work on monitoring the choice of the technology, automations, things like that. And now on non-professional, I spend my weekends cooking. I love cooking. And I do a lot of sports, cycling and trail running.
Fantastic. Yes. Thank you for sharing. All right. And Josephine?
From my part, as much as I can, I travel all around the world, visiting new countries and knowing new people. So I can say that I'm a globetrotter.
Yeah. And you were just in Japan, right?
Yes. Fantastic. Just coming back from Japan. Yes.
Excellent. And you learned a little Japan, a little Japanese?
A little bit. Yeah. I can say I can present myself. Watashi no namae wa Josephine desu. That's it.
Any Japanese people out there who can verify that? Yes? Okay, good. Yeah, all right. Excellent. And, yeah. And Laurent?
Well, outside of business, I'm trying to remain a normal person, so I'm spending lots of time with kids, family, sports. It's hard work and to try to be a normal person, yeah.
Okay, thank you for sharing. Mm-hmm. So this is meant to be called a lightning round, so it's quick, right? What's something that you either learned, observed, enjoyed here at .next that maybe surprised you or that you found a really good takeaway to bring back to the business?
Well, it's my third .next conference.
As an alumni.
I'm very, very glad with that. I hope that the next one will be in one of our hotels. That's very important.
Noted.
It's an opportunity for me to meet other people using the same technology, talk with them, having the same issues, sharing solutions and success stories. But it's also an opportunity for me to talk to the management and product manager from Nutanix, and it's really interesting. I know all of them.
Great.
So that's great, and it's helpful to build our strategy and what we're doing in the data center. I'm particularly interested in the cloud.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you. And Josephine?
For me, it's my very first time here.
Welcome.
It was really interesting. I had the opportunity to talk with my colleagues about infrastructure, hyper-converged solutions, and to hear about also the digital disruption that we all are living now and facing. So it was interesting, yeah.
You're not alone.
Yeah.
No. Okay, how about Laurent?
Yeah, this is my first .next. I'm very happy to be here. I've had a good time. One of the challenges I wanted to discuss with top management have been achieved. I wanted to understand where the company was going and what efforts would be made. And from that perspective, was very interesting. The Nutanix vision is extremely challenging. And as IT leaders, we need to be in sync with innovations and where you are going. And you are definitely one of the leaders of the hyper-converged segment. And moving forward, it's important for us to work closely with you and to understand where you are going.
Yeah, that's important to us too. Keep us honest, keep us hungry, keep us humble. We can only build better products and innovate when we hear from you, so it's important. Okay, so the theme of the conference was all about the enterprise cloud, and I'm curious, you know, where are you in your cloud strategy? Would anybody like to go first? All right, Laurent, you looked at me first. If you look at me, you got to go first.
No. Let's get this one.
Okay.
Well, in our digital transformation, cloud has been identified as a business accelerator. So we are motivated by, we have already some applications running on the cloud, but we want to go further to get more benefits.
And you're doing so, private cloud and public cloud? Or?
Yeah, we've done a model to choose which cloud we will go, and it's based on challenges on one side and benefits on the other, and we have defined four paths. So we put the products, the application in these paths, and we have defined either avoid cloud, embrace public, or experiment, or put in public cloud. We are driven by agility and innovation. Okay. The most important thing is, if I have a recommendation, is to share the same vision with everybody on what is cloud and have the same definition. That's the most important. As far as infrastructure is concerned, as we started doing the hyperconvergence with Nutanix, so we have set already the baseline and the foundations for an hybrid cloud, innovative cloud, and we want to put the IT as a service broker later.
Okay, fantastic. All right, yeah. Josephine?
Yes, L'Oréal is a brand new customer for Nutanix.
Yeah, thank you.
We started our private cloud like a few months ago. We have chosen the hyperconverged solution from Nutanix. And L'Oréal is just entering in the public cloud. It's brand new. We were very cautious about security matters and also the performance between public cloud and our network. So it's brand new, but we are going in. And for the moment, we are very happy, very satisfied. We can feel the flexibility with the hyperconverged solution. So it's a good start.
Yeah, and it's a key initiative for you, mentioned, right?
Yes.
For the next few years.
Exactly, yes.
Okay. And Laurent, how about you? Private cloud, public cloud, hybrid cloud?
Well, we've been operating private cloud for since 2009, providing on-premise solar solutions. They were mainly based on virtualization for our customers. And we are one of the first Nutanix customers since 2014, so for the last three years. Regarding public cloud, what we see as an MSP, we see a huge traction. So most of our customers, they have on-premise solutions and they have already several applications or workloads running on the public cloud. So we have the two sets of services on public and private. One of the importance and what is missing today is how you would administrate and the two silos. Because the customers, for sure, they are going in the two directions.
Okay. You know, as we were talking earlier, you each mentioned that change management in the organization is really important. That's not just about the technology, but you really need to think about the people, too. So I'm wondering if there's anything, any lessons learned, any best practices, or just any thoughts that you want to share on the change management side, the organizational side.
Well, when we started our digital transformation in 2014, we had that stream based on technology, on business, but we focused also on culture and human and people. So the first thing we did is to put a clear vision of what we want. And that vision, we made it simple. It's in two words, it's feel welcome. So it's we wanted to be focused on our customers. Then we changed, we tried to engage also people by setting our values in the companies. And then we communicated a lot. And we have gone further by changing the headquarter of the company. And we have changed also the ways we work. We collaborate, and all these contribute to the success of our digital transformation.
Feel welcome, huh?
Feel welcome.
It's a catchy tag for .next year. Yeah. Feel welcome. I like it. Josephine?
Yes, for my part, change management is fundamental today. If you look at what we are facing with the digital disruption. We have to explain, to communicate, to train our employee. And from my company, we were product centric, and we become more and more consumer centric. So we have to face many changes within the organization, within the way of working, of collaborating with technology, with infrastructure. So we have to explain. Naturally, people don't want to change, they resist. So it's really important to support them and to explain them what we are facing.
Which is interesting, because if you're in IT, change is probably the one constant, right?
Yes,
technology
exactly.
Is always changing, but it is challenging from the people side. Anything you'd like to add, Laurent?
Yes, it's true. What we have seen since 2010, what were acceptable in terms of services in the early days of the cloud, have changed so quickly in the last few years. The customer expectations have changed. The digital transformation, for sure, is there. So we have to adapt, and we are putting a lot of effort in finding the right people and the right technology to sustain and to answer the customer needs. It's by far one of the biggest challenges we have. going back to Nutanix and the changes you are also introducing, mm-hmm. This is where we share the same vision, in fact. You have to adapt, you have to develop new products, hyperconverge, going to enterprise cloud. You need to innovate, you need to have a different mindset. And what we are introducing in our organization is the same. We need to be able to think fast and then to work together. So there are some common attributes between the product you have put on the market and mm-hmm. the energy you are putting behind mm-hmm. and what we are facing.
Mm-hmm. Continuing to drive innovation and disruption. So there's a room full of disruptors here. So I think if you're looking for some key talent, I don't know, maybe people should talk to Laurent after this
come along this panel. And I'll be happy, indeed.
Okay, so we just have a few minutes left. I was just curious, are there any key projects or initiatives that you're currently working on that you might like to share with the audience? Anything that you're bringing over to Nutanix, workloads, applications?
Yes, I have a particular project that we started at the beginning of this year. It concerns the core of our reservation system that is running on Unix today, and we are switching on Nutanix, Linux, mm-hmm. and we adopt virtualization. Mm-hmm. It's really a big jump for us because we leave a technology that been using for many years. Mm-hmm. So we did a great job with the Nutanix team, Dell, and my French partner, S-Cube, and we sized the new platform. We had a particular challenge. We wanted to double the performance mm-hmm. of the actual platform. Mm-hmm. So far, the project, everything is installed, benchmark has been done, and we have more than doubled the performance. So it's, I think it will be a great success.
Great,
we will put in production everything in December.
Okay, is Rajiv out there? He was talking about double performance yesterday, so that's good news. All right, you were telling the truth, man. Good. Okay, Josephine, anything or Laurent that you're working on initiative-wise that you might like to share?
We have chosen Nutanix because we were very worried about the network performance between our server and our SAN. So for the recovery plan, we were thinking about what we can do, what could we improve. So we have chosen Nutanix. It's the first time that we have hyper-convergent solution within the L'Oréal group. Mm-hmm. So we just started, so it's brand new for us. We are in production since, I think, 4 weeks.
Okay.
Everything is going very well. We are very satisfied. We can feel, as I said, really the flexibility, and we will improve the solution, I think, step by step to move all our production on the hyperconverter solution.
Yeah. Any key applications that you're thinking about in particular? I think we talked about.
We will move all our applications.
All your applications.
Yes.
All right, good.
Yes.
All right, Laurent.
Yeah, we're going to keep growing. We have more than 150 nodes on productions. We've been operating Nutanix for 3 years, so we're going to keep growing. We're going to put more .com onto this hyperconverter solution. So mm-hmm. this is a business as usual. Mm-hmm. One of my biggest challenge today is really to find people. Mm-hmm. It's people that can work on the technology, better understand our customers who are going through a digital transformation. Mm-hmm. And this is one of the, working hard on it.
Okay, great. Well, hopefully .next is a really good place to have those conversations. So we only have 2 minutes left. I think you got to catch a plane, is that right?
Yes,
okay. So he's going to be grabbing his luggage and running. So last question for you. Hopefully you'll be sitting here with me at the next.next, which we will announce the location at the end of this session. What do you think, what's your prediction for what we'll be talking about the next time we're back together a year from now?
So there's, I think, a lot of interesting subjects, but I'm particularly watching artificial intelligence and machine learning. Mm-hmm. I think it's interesting tomorrow to get systems, either hardware or software, learning and adapting a set of actions. According to me, it will be the playground or probably the battleground for vendors tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Ahmed.
And what?
Oh, sure. and it's your flight. You can keep
and
talking.
With this machine learning, probably today we have the one click and tomorrow it would be the zero click.
Zero click. All right. Zero clicks. Yeah. Good stuff. I like it. Good.
From my part, I will be very interesting to talk about connected objects.
Connected objects.
Yes. It's the future, but the future is already here, so we have to go fast. And also to speak about how can we simplify. World is too complex today, and we are in the VUCA world, as we said, like volatile, uncertain, complex, ambiguous. So how can we gain in agility, how can we simplify and support our business in the best way as we can. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Okay, predictions, Laurent, for next year?
Yeah, I'm not that good at a visionary, so I would keep or I would stay for hybrid solutions, real hybrid. Mm-hmm. Not going to be silos, something that would help us to manage public and private and would ease our work. So it would be great to talk again about hybrid next year.
Fantastic. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you so much. I really appreciate you spending your time here. I know you're all very busy, so it's so great that you're taking time out of your work schedule to be here in Vienna with us. And I certainly hope we'll see you at either a .next on tour or at .next next year. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Bye-bye. Thank you. Thank you. Okay.